There's a peace I've come to know. Though my heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well.
Good morning and happy Wednesday to you. This is Clint Davis of Chester ARP Church. Thank you for joining us for our congregation's devotional podcast on this Wednesday, July the 22nd. Thank you for being here. Psalm 82. When I read Psalm 82, I can't help but be to think we are living in perhaps one of the most opportune times in human history for the application of this psalm. The title says, Rescue the Weak and Needy. We've heard a lot about that in our society today, haven't we? A lot of discussion about that. Even people asking the questions, does God even care? Do Christians care? Should Christians care about the plight of the weak, about the plight of the needy? And of course, the answer is yes, God does care, and yes, Christians should care, and yes, government leaders should care, and yes, we the people of these great United States, if you're a United States citizen listening to this podcast, we the people of these United States of America should care about the plight of the needy and the plight of the weak. And we should make our leaders accountable to meeting the needs and to assisting where they can within reasons and limits that encourage personal responsibility and provide opportunity and liberty and justice for all. And so we are thankful to be able to have a say in our government. But Psalm 82 is a helpful reminder to us as we think about the times in which we live. Leaders are responsible for others who bear the image of God. Every person that walks on this earth is an image bearer. And as a result, the leaders who are responsible for them are called to imitate God's justice and his compassion. They're even referred to as ministers from a civil point of view, but yet civil authority is not God's minister by divine right. A civil authority is appointed by and rules under God himself. And so when the civil authority does not honor and carry out biblical justice, he abrogates his authority. His justice must be impartial when often it is not. And it must be proactive towards the defenseless. And sometimes it's not. The governor must be an advocate for the weak, because that is a telltale sign of his desire or her desire to pursue righteousness. Ignoring the poor and the needy and the weak is repugnant to God and is idolatrous, and it is adultery. It's spiritual adultery in the eyes of God. And it's a sin that will be punished. And I'm being pretty direct because I think it needs to be said this way. Psalm 82 reminds us of that. As we read it together, we will note that God takes the care of others and the responsibility of those who lead them incredibly seriously. Here's Psalm 82, a psalm of Asaph. God has taken his place in the divine council. In the midst of the gods, he holds judgment. How long will you judge unjustly and show partiality to the wicked? That's a question for the civil authorities who are being unjust, not to God. Give justice to the weak and the fatherless. Maintain the right of the afflicted and the destitute. Rescue the weak and the needy. Deliver them from the hand of the wicked. They have neither knowledge nor understanding. They walk about in darkness. All the foundations of the earth are shaken. I say you are gods, sons of the Most High, all of you. Nevertheless, like men, you shall die and fall away, fall like any prince. Arise, O God, and judge the earth, for you shall inherit the nations. As I read that last little bit of verse 6 and 7, where the psalmist says to the unjust rulers, you are gods, sons of the Most High, all of you, they are Israelites, but nevertheless, like men, you shall die, you shall fall like any prince. Can't help but think of Haman, the great enemy of God's people, whose responsibility was to protect and care for all peoples under his rule. He was anti-Semitic and despised the Jews, the Israelites. He even built a gallows upon which he was going to hang Mordecai. And yet, in a turn of fortune, By the grace, mercy, and providence of God, Haman ended up hanging on his own gallows, and Mordecai was exalted because God had chosen to show up and judge the earth through the influence of Esther. I want to encourage you today, pray for your leaders that they be righteous, but hold them accountable. And we must seek to ensure that we are all working together to elevate the glory of Christ, to remember the image bearer, and to care for those who are in need, and to deliver the weak and be there for the fatherless. For as James says, all true and wonderful religion is there to meet the needs of the widows and the fatherless. You guys have a great day. Take that responsibility seriously. Let's bring justice to the earth as we seek to imitate the justice of God. Have a great day. Take care. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.
There's a peace I've come to know. Though my heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well.